Rise up, they say. Can you stand up, my brother? There's a demon in your family.
Yes, sir.
People used to worship this idol.
It's true, sir.
And you have been visited by something that used to chase you.
It's true, sir.
You wake up and pray all the time.
Yes, sir. Every time I'm awake at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Try to pray against this thing.
Yes, sir.
And God loves you.
Amen.
Does God want to use you?
Yes, sir.
Come. This demon must leave you.
Come.
You demon, what do you do to him? Huh? Put a mic. It's a demon. Huh? What do you do to him? Speak out. Huh? Why are you blocking him? Fire all over your body. Demon. You're an idol. 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 So why are you blocking him?
No.
Huh? Who knows this brother? Who knows him? You know him? How do you know him?
He's my pastor.
He's your pastor?
Amen.
Where?
In Botswana.
In Botswana.
Amen.
You people, you are. Can you just come? Where is that other lady? How do you block him?
I block this prayer.
Huh?
I block this prayer.
You block his prayer.
He struggles to pray.
He struggles to pray.
Yes.
So. So. You knew he's going to come here, isn't it?
Yes.
Huh?
He wanted to come.
Huh?
He
and
wanted
and
to
you
come.
Were blocking him.
Yes.
He wanted to be here for a long time, so they were blocking.
So, leave him today, leave him. In Jesus' name. You are defeated today. In Jesus' name. So, you are.
Sir, can you please introduce yourself to us and also confirm the prophecy that you received today, whether to be true or not?
My name is Pastor Allen Leswale from Botswana. I received a prophecy from the man of God saying people from my family, they used to worship idols, which I confirmed it is very true. From my mother's side, they used to worship idols. So what he said, it's very true.
How are they affecting you? Because the man of God cannot speak about idols if they are not affecting you as a pastor. What is really happening to your ministry, your life and your family?
Firstly, I got married last year, December. It was a battle for me to finally get married, but we ended up doing the marriage by the God's grace. And secondly, the ministry. Lately, I've been having a hard time to pray. Like, I'm always awake at 3, but it's like there's something that is pinning me down not to pray, but it is true. What you are saying, it is true. It has limited a lot of things, my academics, even ministry-wise. Even now, things are coming up, but I'm still struggling. But it has affected a lot of things in my family. The family is not united. They are fighting. So that's how those who are in the light and those who are still believing in those idols, the family is still separated, which is now going to cause a problem to our children.
You, as a minister of God who preaches the truth, who preaches about Jesus, how has this thing affected you? Because in the church, you teach people that Jesus is the way, but while in your own family, there are division. How is it affecting?
It has affected me because whenever I preach about such things, it makes me think of where I'm coming from, what is happening back home. So, but I ended up encouraging myself in the Lord that one day there shall be light in my family, because we are praying that may they receive the light of God.
And today, by the grace of God, the man of God was able to locate you and speak about the things that are really happening in your life. How are you feeling?
I'm really happy that the grace of God located me. I believe that as I leave this place, my life will never be the same. And he also talked about the ministry. He said people shall begin to know about the church, which we are still trying to build up the branch. And I thank God he has also spoke a word unto it.
Hallelujah.
We really thank God.
God.
Amen. Thank you, sir.
How are you related with this man?
Well,
yes.
We are just fellowshipping from one church, but I'm in headquarters. They're in Boka branch. With us.
So you came together from Botswana?
Yes, sir.
Brother, this man will be surprised. Come here, Reza. I want to tell you that people will start to recognize your minister.
Amen.
You hear me?
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Come on. Because you people here in this church, all of you are under attack.
Yes.
It's not true.
Yes.
Eh?
It's true.
You people, you are failing to marry.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
all
true.
Of you, all
very,
of you.
Very true.
It's like you are under a cage.
Very true.
This brother is possessed. Is what? He's possessed, this brother. Can you put Mike in his mouth? What I do to him? Huh? Speak out. What are you doing? Why do you block him? You demon. Could you just put Mike in also their mouth there? What I do to her? Huh? Speak out. Can you speak out? I apply fire on you. Come on. Brother, where is he? Can you see everybody's?
Yes, sir. There? They are fighting with anti-marriage, both of them.
Huh?
They are fighting against anti-marriage.
It's what I'm
where
saying.
They are coming from.
It's what I'm saying, my brother. You know this lady, they don't want her to marry.
Yes, sir.
And then also there are some people who normally influence her in a wrong way.
Yes, sir, it's true.
Huh? So
it's true, sir.
She needs to leave people now.
Yes, sir.
Because they realize that God wants to use this lady.
Yes, sir.
She have to marry a pastor.
My name is Agifilwe Banana Dimpa. I'm from Botswana. I'm here to confirm the prophecy of the man of God. First, I want to thank God that the man of God had a word of a prophecy upon my life, which I believe has brought a deliverance and a change into my life. The prophecy that man of God gave me is 100% true. He prophesied that I'm possessed, and he also mentioned that the friends that I go with are the ones that are like advising me wrongly, which I believe is 100% true, because I do have kind of questions, and I don't know how can I put it, with, let's say, my concerning my relationship, but I do. Some people will be like kind of saying this and that to me, which at times I believe. Or I tend to believe maybe they're advising me in a good way, but at the same time, I would say that what man of God said is just 100%. Really, I feel light about it, because you know what, it has been weighing me down, not knowing where I am going to be 100% sure. And I believe that what man of God has just said has brought deliverance into my life, and I believe that everything has changed.
Thank you. Greetings. My name is Rebetswa Robert Zile from Botswana, fellowship at Eagle Nest, the Boka Church. Indeed, the man of God prophesied over my life about the stagnation, and then also about the demon that is blocking everything, including the marriage. I can confirm that indeed it's true. My business hasn't been doing very well, and also in my life I haven't been really doing well too. And I could have been married in, I'd say, maybe 2 years back, but I haven't got married even now. But I believe that whatever that he has said over my life, and him also touching me, releasing all those things, it means that I believe that they will come to pass now. Amen. I'm feeling so blessed. I'm feeling so blessed, and I believe that it was really a divine appointment for me to step in this place. And then for the first time, then the man of God managed to pick me up. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Thank you.